Hello friends, welcome back to my channel English Wave. My name is Gurbhesra and today we are going to discuss passage 3 of reading 2 for Cambridge 1. So let's start the discussion. For question number 28 to 32, we have to choose the most suitable headings for each paragraph from the given list of headings. So matching or finding headings is being a nightmare for most of the students. And today, I'm going to explain how to approach these type of questions, how to skim the paragraph, to find the clue words, and to how to locate the topic sentence. So to begin with, we will start with studying the paragraph A. Tourism, holiday making, and travel are these days more significant social phenomena than most commentators have considered. So in the first three lines, the writer has explained the significance of tourism. Let's quickly skim through the paragraph while being attentive towards clue words and topic sentence. On the face of it means without knowing all the relevant facts. There could be a more trivial subject. Trivial subject means subject of no importance or low importance. They would have great difficulties in accounting for more trivial phenomena such as holiday making. For a book, and indeed since social scientists have had considerable difficulty explaining weightier topics such as work or politics. So here it is explained that this is very difficult for social scientists, that which is more weightier topic, work or politics. So, however, there are interesting parallels with the study of deviance. This involves the investigation of bizarre and idiosyncratic social practices. Bizarre means an eccentric behavior of the people, and idiosyncratic means individual. So, idiosyncratic social practices which happen to be defined as deviant in some societies, but not necessarily in other. The assumption is that the investigation of deviance can reveal interesting and significant aspects of normal societies. It could be said that a similar analysis can be applied to tourism. It could be said that the similar analysis can be applied to tourism. Try to understand these lines. So in the last line, the writer is just trying to convince the readers that the study of tourism is as important as other studies like social studies and work and politics. So let's find out the heading in the list. So firstly, for the paragraph B, answer is already given as an example. So I'll strike through this option. Ninth. Now we are remaining with 8 headings. So let's study the politics of tourism. No mention about the politics of tourism. Second, the cost of tourism. There is no mention about the cost. Number 3, justifying the study of tourism. Yes, this is our answer. Justifying. The writer is trying to justify that study of tourism is also important. This is not a trivial subject. This is also important. So this is our answer. So I'll strike through this and I'll put 3 here. So let's return to paragraph B. So tourism is a leisure activity. Leisure activity means the activity we do in our leisure time, in our free time, which presupposes its opposite, namely regulated and organized work. Presupposes means make it necessary, to make it compulsory. Its opposite, namely regulated and organized work. So it is one manifestation of how work and leisure are organized as separate and regulated spheres of social practice in modern societies. Indeed, acting as a tourist is one of the defining characteristics of the being modern. Acting as a tourist is one of the defining characteristics of the being modern. This can be a clue. And popular concept of tourism is that it is organized within particular places and occurs for regularized periods of time. Tourist relationships arise from the movements of people to and their stays in various destinations. This necessarily involves some movements, that is the journey and a period of stay in a new place or places. Now we are talking about modern tourism. This necessarily involves means modern tourism involves. Means we are talking about necessary things that involves in the modern tourism. The journey and the stay are by definition outside the normal places of residence and the work and are of a short term and a temporary nature, and there is a clear intention to return home within a relatively short period of time. Means these are the necessary things which are related to modern tourism. Let's find out in the list of headings. See the heading number 5. The essence of modern tourism. Essence means essential things. So this is our answer. So I'll strike through this option and I'll put 5 here. Let's continue reading the paragraph C. Substantial portion of the population of modern societies engages in such tourism practices. New socialized forms of provision have developed in order to tackle with these things. With the mass character of the gazes of tourists. Mass character means a lot of people are there. Mass character of the gazes of tourists. Gazes of tourists means expectations of the tourists. As opposed to the individual character of travel places. As opposed to means opposite of that. Individual character of the travel places are chosen to be visited and be gazed upon because there is an anticipation, especially through daydreaming. Anticipations means expectations. Especially through daydreaming. Daydreaming means to be lost in the thoughts. To be lost in the thoughts of particular place. And fantasy of intense pleasure, either on a different scale or involving different senses from those customarily encountered. Such anticipations is constructed and sustained through a variety of non-tourist practices. Non-tourist practices means without visiting a places, to think about any place where we want to visit. Such as film, TV, literature, magazines, records and videos, which construct and reinforce this daydream. Ultimately, what writer wants to say in simple lines, he's just trying to compare the two things here, tourism and travel. So these are two different things. So I have learned from this passage that some people make some anticipations, means expectations for any particular place based on the non-tourist practices, such as by watching on the TV, magazines and videos, or by reading about those places and start daydreaming about that place and start having the pleasure. But as a traveler, when one visits the place, that makes a difference. So there is an opposition between two things, tourism and traveling. So this is the topic sentence of this paragraph. So let's find out in the list of headings. Politics of tourism, no. Cost, no cost is mentioned. Third is already taken. Tourism contrasted with travel. Yes, this is our answer. This is the most suitable heading. Tourism contrasted with travel. So this will be our answer. So I'll strike through it and I'll put 4 here. So paragraph D is already answered. Then I'll go to paragraph E. Let's continue reading. One of the earliest dissertations on the subject tourism is, dissertations means detailed study of the subject, is Boorstin's analysis of the pseudo-event. Boorstin, so Daniel Boorstin, we are talking about Daniel Boorstin. Daniel Boorstin was an American historian who explained the pseudo-event. So pseudo-event means an event arranged or brought about merely for the sake of publicity it generates. So it is just an artificial event, which is a deliberately generated pseudo event. So where he argues that contemporary Americans cannot experience reality directly, but thrive on pseudo event isolated from the host environment and the local people, the mass tourist travels in the guided groups and finds pleasure in inauthentic contrived attractions. Contrived attractions means deliberately created attractions. That's what most of the guides do. Contrived attractions, gullibly enjoying the pseudo events. Gullibly means in a naive way. Gullible tourists are the tourists which are easily tricked by the guides. So gullibly enjoying the pseudo events and disregarding the real world. Disregarding means ignoring. Disregarding the real world outside. Over time, the images generated of different tourist sites come to constitute a closed self-perpetuating system of illusions which provide the tourist with the basis of selecting. So if we try to understand his opinion in simple lines, means tourists are often taken by guides to their contrived attractions and they are guided in a way that they enjoy and find pleasure in them. And in this way, tourists are divided of the real beauty of the place. So this is the central idea of this passage. Let's find out the heading for this paragraph. Politics. Coast, no. Tourism versus leisure, no. Yes, the artificiality of modern tourism. Artificiality, not real. Artificiality of modern tourism. This is our answer. So I'll strike through this option and I'll put 7 here. We are remaining with only one question of this type. So let's read the paragraph F. So to service the burgeoning tourist industry, an array of professionals has developed. Burgeoning in tourist industry means, burgeoning means flourishing or increasing rapidly. An array of professionals means series of professionals. Means a lot of professionals has developed who attempt to reproduce our new objects. Professionals here means guides for the tourists who attempt to reproduce our new objects for the tourist to look at. These objects or places are located in a complex and changing hierarchy. This depends on the interplay between, on the one hand, competition between interests involved in the provision of such objects. Means we are talking about interests of the tourists. And on the other hand, changing class, gender and generational distinctions of the taste within the potential population of visitors. Means here writer is talking about that interest of the tourist changes with the class, with the gender and the, with other things. It has been said that to be a tourist is one of the characteristics of the modern experience. Not to go away is like not possessing a car or a nice house. Travel is a marker of status in modern societies and is also thought to be necessary for good health. The role of professional, therefore, is to cater for the needs and the tastes of the tourists in accordance with the with their class and overall expectations. Means here we are talking about the role of professionals, means role of the guides in the tourist industry. Let's find out in the list. And here it is our answer. It was easy. The role of modern tour guides. This is our answer. So I'll put it here. So this is the approach we should follow to tackle these type of questions. Let's move on to the next type of questions. Questions 33 to 37. Do the following statements agree with the views of the writer in writing passage 3? Yes, if the statements agree. No, if contradicts. Are not given, as we already know that if it is possible to say what the writer thinks about this. Means we don't have the information in the passage to decide whether it is yes or no. Okay, let's read the questions. Question number 33. The tourism is a tribal subject. Let's highlight some keywords. Tribal subject. Tribal subject. An analysis of the deviance can act as a model for the analysis of tourism. Means there is a comparison between deviance and tourism. 35th, tourists usually choose to travel overseas. Overseas. Tourists focus more on places they visit than those at home. There is also comparison here. Focus more on places they visit or at home. 37, tour operators try to cheat tourists. Tour operators and cheat tourists. So these are some keywords we have to look for while studying the paragraph. Let's find out these keywords in the passage. So first of all, read the paragraph A. Tourism, holiday making and travel are these days more significant social phenomena than most commentators have considered. As we already know that what is the meaning of tribal subject? The subject of no importance or low importance. So as it is clear from this line, that tourism or holiday making is not a tribal subject. It is more significant social phenomena than most commentators have considered. So our answer would be no. So our answer of 33 questions will be no. An analysis of deviance can act as a model for the analysis of tourism. So question number 34, we will study the same paragraph. As we already know that in the first paragraph, it is mentioned about the study of deviance and study of tourism. So let's read it. The study of deviance. This involves an investigation of bizarre and idiosyncratic social practices which happens to be defined as deviant in some societies but not necessarily in others. The assumption is that the investigation of deviance can reveal interesting and significant aspects of normal societies. It could be said that a similar analysis can be applied to tourism. This last line reflects our answer. An analysis of deviance can act as a model for the analysis of tourism. So our answer would be yes. So I'll put Y here. Next question is, tourists usually choose to travel overseas. Let's find out in the passage. As we have studied the whole passage when we were finding the headings, but about the tourist preferences, whether they want to travel overseas or they want to visit the local places. Preferences for the tourists are not mentioned anywhere. So our answer would be not given. So I'll put not given. Tourists focus more on places they visit than those at home. Let's find out in the passage. So for this, read the paragraph D, starting from people linger over these sites in a way that they would not normally do in their home environment. Linger over these sites means to stay there for a long time. So people usually do the things around those places where they usually visit and that they would not normally do in their home environment, at their home. So let's put the answer, and our answer would be yes. Question number 37. Tour operators try to cheat tourists. Let's find out in the passage. Although this is mentioned about the pseudo events by the Boorstins, the guide or tour operators usually take the tourist to their desired places. But there is no mentioned about that they try to cheat the tourist. So our answer would be not given. So I'll put not given here. Let's move on to next type of questions. Question number 38 to 41. You have to choose one phrase, A to H, from the list of phrases. To complete each key point below, write the appropriate letters A to H in boxes 38 to 41. Means we have to study the questions 38 to 41 and we have to complete each key point. So for this, read the paragraph B. Tourism is a leisure activity which presupposes its opposite, namely regulate and organized work. It is one manifestation. Manifestation means description of how work and leisure are organized as separate work and leisure. Two things are there, are organized as separate. So from this we can analyze our answer. Read the D phrase. The distinction we make between work and leisure. Distinction means separate. So our answer would be D. So I'll put D here. Question number 39. The media can be used to enhance, to match it. Let's find out in the passages. So for this, read the paragraph C, the later part of the paragraph C, starting from such anticipations is constructed and sustained through a variety of non-tourist practices such as films, TV, literature, magazines, records and videos, which construct and reinforce this daydreaming. Daydreaming is based on the anticipations. So our answer is done. Let's see the phrase. So the media can be used to enhance the expectations of tourists. So our answer would be B. So I'll put B here. Question number 40. People view tourist landscapes in a different way from. Let's find out. So for this, read the paragraph D. Tourists tend to visit features of landscape and townscape which separate them off from everyday experience. Such aspects are viewed because they are taken to be in some sense out of the ordinary. So people view tourist landscapes in a different way from places seen in everyday life. Places seen in everyday life. So our answer would be F. लास्ट क्वेश्चन, ग्रुप टूर्स एनकरेज पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू लुक एट, फॉर दिस रीड द पैराग्राफ एफ, टू सर्विस द बर्जनिंग टूरिस्ट इंडस्ट्री एंड एरे ऑफ प्रोफेशनल्स हैज डेवलप्ड, हु अटेम्प्ट टू प्रोड्यूस एवर न्यू ऑब्जेक्ट्स फॉर द टूरिस्ट टू लुक एट. From this, we can analyze our answer. Let's have a look at the phrases. Group tours encourage participants to look at sites designed specially for tourists. Yes, this is our answer. And I'll put H here. So this was all about this passage. Let's discuss some important words from the passage. So our first word is travel subject. Travel subject means a subject of no or less importance. That is travel subject. And next is bizarre. Bizarre, as we have already studied, bizarre means eccentric or unusual. The thing which is eccentric or unusual. That is bizarre. Then idiosyncratic. Idiosyncratic means individualism. Then presupposes. Presupposes means to make anything essential. That is presupposes. Then anticipations. Anticipations means expectations. Anticipations means expectations. Then daydreaming. Daydreaming means to be lost in thoughts while awaking. Then dissertations. Dissertations means detailed study or thesis, we can say. Then disregarding. Disregarding means ignoring. One word more is there, illusions. Illusion means something that many people believe but is false. That is illusion. Erroneous things. That is illusion. Then self-perpetuating. Self-perpetuating means carrying on by self. To continue anything by self. That is self-perpetuating. Then our next word is burgeoning. Burgeoning means flourishing or increasing rapidly, we can say. So that's all about this passage. If you like this video, please do share with your friends. Like my videos. And press the bell icon to have notifications on new updates. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.